to solve the numerical, try to concentrate all of you. We'll just discuss the part related with our numerical, how to solve, and one numerical will solve. So for solving numericals, factors will be provided, that is 20H7G8 likewise, and evaluate the type of fit. Such type of questions will be asked. And in that, so if 20 value is provided, so where that 20 comes, it will be in between 18 and 30. So you can say that over here. So always first we have to calculate the mean diameter, geometric mean. So it will be d minimum and d maximum. So what will the value of d minimum? It will be nothing but 18 d minimum and 30 d maximum. And for that we can calculate d, capital D, which will be the geometric mean. So for 20 basic size, this diametrical zone or range of diameters we can use. Next one, after finding d, we can go for tolerance calculation, that is standard tolerance value I, which will be in micron always. You have to remember this. So the formula for that will be this, and you can identify and calculate I. With that, next step will be the deviations. Now, based on which type of hole is provided, we can identify it. So find the fundamental deviation for the hole. Fundamental deviation will depend on whether it is A, B, C, up till ZC. Out of that, which one is provided, and we can get that value from the table. Likewise, find the limits of sizes, that is lower limit and upper limit for both hole and shaft. It will be nothing but basic size. Then standard tolerance, we can go the table. I will show you with that the hole dimensions, we can get it. And then we have numerical we'll try to solve. Now calculate the limit, tolerance and allowances. Three factors are asked. Limits you have to calculate. Now since limits means you have to find out maximum and minimum, that is upper and lower limit. For what factors? Internal, external, that is for a hole and for a shaft. For both you have to find out, because capital H is provided and small f is provided. That means a shaft is there and a hole is there. So fitment is there. So obviously whenever fitment is there, allowance can be calculated. And with that, tolerance for both can be found out. Now how to find this? So first step, I told you, find the diameter range. So over here, 40 is the basic size. So it lies where? In between 30 and 50. Zone provided is 30, 50. So D minimum will be your 30 mm and D maximum will be your 50 mm. Now we can immediately get D, which will be equal to under root of 30 into 50. Which will be equal to 38.373 mm. With that, now tolerance unit or tolerance value, we can get it as I, based on this formula, as 1.56 microns. So which we can convert it in millimeters, that is 0.00156 mm. After getting that, next step will be find the fundamental deviation. Now which type of hole it is? H type of hole is shown over here. So if you observe this diagram, H hole just lies on the zero line, this one, this part. So fundamental deviation for H, fundamental deviation means, I told you, the shortest distance. The shortest distance is obviously zero. So fundamental deviation for H hole will be zero. Likewise, you can say that lower deviation is fundamental deviation for H hole. Now, so lower limit of hole we can identify, it will be nothing but basic size was nothing but 40 mm and fundamental deviation is zero. So obviously we'll get it as 40 mm. In similar case, we can go for other limit, upper limit. So for calculating upper limit, we have to find out this value, this distance, this total block size. This total block size can be found out based on the table, this one. This table I told you. So which type of grade is provided? H8 grade is provided. So what does this 8 indicate? 8, I mean IT8. So IT8 is nothing but 25i from the table. So 25i means just substitute value of I, tolerance unit, which was 0.00156 multiplied by 25, you will get the tolerance value. So this value 0.039 mm, this one is the size of this tolerance value. So this block is nothing but it has a height of 0.039 millimeter. Now we can go for tolerance upper limit calculation. Upper limit will be either basic size plus fundamental deviation plus tolerance, or either lower limit plus tolerance over here if you observe. So this will be lower limit of hole and this will be the upper limit. So upper limit will be nothing but lower limit plus this distance, and this distance we already calculated. So it will be 40.039. Similar case, this was related with H8 hole. Now shaft F, small F shaft is given. You can observe it over here. This one, F shaft. So it has some distance, some gap, obviously upper limit and zero line. So in earlier slide which you observed, ES or EI will be the fundamental deviation, obviously ES because upper limit. So ES you have to find out. So ES can be found out based on this fundamental deviation, 5 point. This can be, we can get it over here. So this F, we have the standard table of fundamental deviations for shaft. So we have F type of shaft. So this one. So standard formula for F is provided as this. So you can use that formula and you can identify the fundamental deviation. Obviously, it will be negative because it is below the zero line. So value will be negative, minus 0.02462. This you have to identify. So whenever any alphabet changes, you can get it directly the value over here from this. And in similar fashion, we can get both values of upper and lower limit. So upper limit as addition of fundamental deviation. So standard tolerance, similarly, it was 25 IT 8 only. So 8 means 25 I. So in similar fashion, we can get the value as 0.039, similar. So both limits we can find out. So for 40 small f, by mistake it is capital R. So its limits can be found out. So we can go with this.